Welcome to part one. In this part of the course, we will discuss some basic terms, concepts, and tools necessary for writing and running our programs. Before we get to the Java programming language, I would like to discuss what a program is in any language. A program is a set of instructions which can be inputted, understood, and executed by an information processing system, or IPS. What is an IPS? Well, to be specific, I define an IPS as anything which has the following characteristics. Some kind of input-output systems, like a keyboard, mouse, monitor, ears, eyeballs, or vocal cords, all of which can take information in and out of the system. It must also have some way of representing and storing the information in various forms, such as numbers, letters, images, sounds, and so forth. Finally, it must be capable of processing the information, usually to solve some kind of problem. Now that we understand what an IPS is, recall that a program is a set of instructions which can be inputted, understood, and executed by an IPS. Therefore, we might say that a recipe is just like a program which is executed by a cook. Similarly, if a person wants to improve their health, they can look up an exercise program, which is a set of instructions on exercises to achieve that goal. There are many different kinds of information processing systems, and there are many different kinds of programs. We will, of course, be focusing on programs written in the Java programming language. Now, it turns out that several steps are required for our Java code to actually be understood by a computer, and that is what we will look at in the next few lessons.